The suspect was evading arrest. I chased him through the motel room, out the broken bathroom window, down the fire escape stairs, into the alley.
And when did you draw your weapon?
Before I entered the room.
And you went in ready to use it?
A civilian was in danger.
A civilian you intentionally put in danger? You engaged in an off-duty investigation with no backup. Unauthorized use of a civilian decoy, and you were following procedures, Detective Page?
I had a known location on a wanted murder suspect. I made a decision to move on it before he got away again.
You know, that sounds good. That's not the right answer.
It's the only answer I got.
Detective Page had pursued Lester Richards before.
Yes, we had some run-ins. Drugs, robbery, assault. His want cards at the top of the pile.
Your partner kept a little trophy. Lester's sweatshirt. Hung it on the wall above his desk.
It's just a reminder of the one that got away, that's all.
Maybe the one he was definitely going to get. Why did you go to the scene, Kevin? Or did you just happen to be in the neighborhood?
I was concerned that...
Say, Detective Page might do something stupid?
No. I went because I was his partner.
And I'm supposed to believe that?
There's no other version to the story.
You're telling me while Lester's running down the fire escape, he turns around and aims at you while trying to flee?
That's correct.
And you responded by discharging your weapon 3 times.
If that's what it says, yeah. He drew on me first.
So it's either him or you.
Lester Richards was a pimp, a drug dealer, a murderer.
And you hunted him down.
I did my job.
There's a helmet law in D.C.?
Oh, yeah.
Why are you wearing one?
Forgot, I guess.
Guy's in a big hurry to get on with his midlife crisis, forgets the details. Step off the bike, please, sir. License and registration, please.
You got it. There you go.
Thank you, Mr. Mannion. I'm sorry, I just got transferred over from Park Police Chief.
Sure.
I mean, sir, it's an honor to meet you.
You also, Netherwood.
Netherwood.
You're new.
Yes, sir.
Well, listen, Netherwood.
Yes, sir.
This is not a midlife crisis. This is a harlot.
Sorry. I didn't mean...
Yeah. Doing your job.
Have a good day, Chief.
You also. Thank you. Hey, Netherwood.
Sir.
You forget something? You're supposed to do your job. You give me a ticket.
Yes, sir.
You bet.
Hey, can you believe those jackals?
The whole police department's in the spotlight now that Mannion's gone. Those guys are just doing their job.
So you're cool with internal affairs now that you're working for them? Hunter's looking to hang my ass. It doesn't matter how I did it. I did a good thing.
You know what? That's exactly the attitude that's gotten us into this mess in the first place.
You got a problem with me?
We're not even supposed to be talking, okay?
Kevin, what did you tell them? You have my back, right?
I told them what you told me.
Lester drew on me first.
Then you got nothing to worry about, buddy.
Okay. Everyone head in.
Vance, I want to be a cop again. And before you say anything about how you tried to help me out before, but I gave up because I was feeling sorry for myself, just let me say, yes, I was a weenie.
Sucked up another hamster?
I was just scampering there in front of the nozzles, trying to get away. I kept thinking, you know, you're resisting arrest. After that, I don't remember much. I just want my job back.
You and Mannion.
She's back.
It's been exciting.
Really? You look good.
Thank you for your cooperation. Appreciate you coming down. If we have any more questions, we'll call you.
Thank you. This investigation seems to be going a little beyond routine procedure. What exactly are you digging for, Hunter?
The truth, detective. Are all Jack Mannion's disciples this way? Think you can do whatever you want? He's gone, you know. He's not chief anymore.
Temple Page is a good cop.
And that's what you were thinking when you left work early, drove all the way across town, and entered that alley?
Look, if you've got something on him, let me know. Give me a chance to help him.
Perhaps you've gotten a little too close to this, Kevin. Perhaps you should turn over your cases, take a couple of days off. Thank you. Better yet, I'll see about a department transfer. Pretty interesting. K-9, auto theft.
Come on, Hunter. I just want to know where you're going with this, that's all.
You know, DeBrino, there are two types of cops that really get under my skin. Those that stick their nose where they don't belong, and the ones who hide behind the badge to play vigilante. That puts you and your partner at the top of my list.
Ah, well, see, it's got to be the belt buckle. This is handmade by Chief Blackwater of the Shoshone tribe. Be careful there.
Don't let him in here. He's only going to stir up trouble.
Joe Nolan? I recognize that baritone voice. And, give me a hug. Big hug. Come on. Big old hug.
You keep that up, you're going to make me blush.
All right, good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
When'd you get back in town?
This morning. They gave me a ticket for not wearing a helmet. I think I'm being profiled.
Right.
You want to check into that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how's Temple?
He's in the thick of it, Jack. Internal Affairs is under a lot of pressure to clean up the image of the department. They're in a hurry, and Temple's their poster child. You didn't come all the way down here just to get me to fix that ticket, did you?
No, I came here to get my job back.
Jack, you've been riding in the sun too long. Mayor's going to appoint a new police chief within the week. Two names not on the list, yours and mine.
Mm-hmm. So that gives us 3 days. That's plenty of time.
Jack, get a job somewhere, all right? Baltimore, Atlanta, New Orleans. You could turn those places around in your sleep.
I ain't finished here yet, Joe. Now, come on, you and I, we can make it.
No, we. I want to collect my pension and watch my little girl grow up, Jack, all right? I'll see you in a second. Give me a minute.
Huh? Yeah.
Joe!
No!
Hey! Come on, where's the spunk? Joe!
Jack!
Joe!
Jack!
Howdy. There are a lot of new people here. Oh, my. This time, I was in the Grand Tetons and the wind was howling. Mountain pass, And I was having a real hard time keeping the bike upright, and Cujo's whining, so I figured, well, stop in this rest stop, sit down, you know, get rid of the anxiety attack. Next thing I know, down the road comes this Harley, and there's this guy on it in a blue shirt with a scarf, long black hair. He's an Indian, and he sits down next to me in the rest stop, and he says, you having trouble riding in the wind? I says, yeah, I am. And he says, well, you got to lean into it. Don't resist. Is that you? Come on. That's what I thought, because I remember when I got here for the first time, you said, Jack, this town is all about politics, son. If you don't play the game, you're gonna have to sit on the bench. Well, you were right. But I'm back, and I'm ready to play. And I gotta tell you, baby, I got game. Yes, I do.
I heard you were back in town. I thought you'd look different.
Hi.
Hi.
My new campaign poster. Huh?
You do know that the chief of police job isn't an elected office.
Yeah. Good to see you. Mm-hmm. You look great. Yeah, but see, that's the beauty of the concept, Kavanaugh. I'm going to get some public support, you know, drum up some good old groundswell, you know, and that way the mayor's going to have to give my job back. Do you think the letters are too small?
Huh. You and Sherry come up with this on the interstate, Jack?
Sherry? No, she dumped me on the road trip somewhere in Arizona. I was thinking about jumping the Grand Canyon on the bike.
There is an easier way to get your job back, Jack. The mayor fired you claiming obstruction of justice. His evidence was a tape-recorded call from your cell phone, but it was an illegal wiretap by the Justice Department. Simple as that. Yeah. You got him.
Well, okay, well, let's say we do it your way, all right? I just throw all my cards right there on the table. I go to the mayor, I tell him I want my job back, or I'm going to go to the media and expose his connection to the illegal wiretapping that leads all the way to the Attorney General. Let's say I do that.
It's your very own Watergate, Jack.
Or,
you'll be back in your office by noon tomorrow.
Or I hold those cards, because I think it's smarter if I know that he doesn't know that I know.
Unbelievable.
What? What is?
That actually made sense to me.
Kavanaugh, I want my job back the old-fashioned way. I'm going to earn it.
In 3 days?
So I'm the underdog. I love being the underdog.
Oh, boy, you are under the underdog, Jack. Use the tape.
Oh, you're smiling?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, you know. Hey, if you have any suggestions, additions, subtractions, retractions, anything else that ends in T-I-O-N, you just call me.
Kashmir, we need to talk.
I'm working.
Well, maybe you should take a break.
I've answered all the questions I'm going to answer. There's an empty chair over there if you'd like a haircut.
That's cool. I'll wait. Excuse us, will you?
Make it quick.
Okay. What did you tell IA?
I spent 2 days answering questions. They said I'm done. I'm done. You're not supposed to be here.
That's true. I'm here for myself. I need to know what you saw.
Partner had a score to settle.
Yeah, but Lester had a gun, right?
He was born with one.
Did he try and shoot Temple Page?
No. Lester was trying to surrender.
What, he was throwing his weapon to the ground?
No, he was turning and raising his hands. I was at the window. I saw everything. Your friend didn't yell, stop, freeze, police. He just fired. I gotta go.
I'm here about the apartment.
Hey, come here. Put your weight on this for me for a sec.
Yeah.
Come on.
All right.
I need some help. You know, whatever you do, don't let that go.
Why don't you get a plumber?
Plumber? Telephone repairman, electrician, honey, you were looking at her. Hey, do me a favor. Hand me that Phillips. Come on. Come on, get it. You know what
Phillips
is like. Come on, hurry up. I told you to keep your weight on it.
Yeah,
all right. Well, you want to see that apartment?
Like a towel.
Come on, I got one inside.
How's the sink up in the apartment I'm going to be looking at?
It's great. My Saturday school is right below you, so the only thing I ask is that you keep your music down until after 3. You pay your own utilities, except for water.
Thanks for the towel.
You're welcome.
Okay, I'll take it.
You really want to rent a place in this neighborhood?
Yeah.
I mean, honey, look at you. The people in this neighborhood, they're... Now, wouldn't you be more comfortable someplace close to, what, valet parking?
This is home. Reminds me of home. It's like New York. Smells like New York.
Yeah, don't worry. I'll take care of that.
All right, so, what, your ad mentioned first, last, and security, right?
Oh, wait, just hold on. You're moving a little too fast for me. Hmm. Hey, aren't you the Jack Mannion that was just fired by the mayor as chief of police?
That's correct. I'm not going to use him as a reference, though. So if you're worried about the rent, I can cover it.
Oh, okay. You know what? I'm on to you. I got you. See ya. So you move into this neighborhood. Nice photo ops, right? Makes for a great headline. But you know, let me tell you something. The folks around here, they're not going to buy it. And the lease on this place, it's not month to month.
No, wait. Just hold it, all right? You're right. I'm going to take the place to make a statement, but it's not what you think. You see, 60% of the MPD officers that patrol in the district, they don't live in the district. And I think if you're going to police the people, you live amongst the people. And that starts with me.
You aren't the chief anymore.
It's a minor detail.
You know what? You might as well just face it. You're just another MTP.
What?
MTP, momentary transplant. Just like all those other government transients that makes decisions about this city and its citizens, and you don't even live here.
No, wait a minute. I mean, just stop going on for a minute. You know, I love this city. I want to live in this city a long time. I had my first near-death experience in this city. You know, it's very close to my heart. And I probably know more about this city than you do.
Oh, yeah? Think you do?
Yeah, I know.
All right.
Yeah.
Who was Howard University named after?
General Oliver Howard, Civil War hero.
Or when was the first inaugural parade?
1809.
How many dragons are on the Chinatown Arch?
Excuse me. The correct name is the Friendship Archway. 300 painted dragons built in 1986. Is that the best you could do? Come on.
Longest escalator.
Wheaton Station.
Best gumbo.
Calvin's on K. Oldest black church.
Mount Zion. You still want the apartment?
Absolutely. With a few modifications.
I'm doing all I'm gonna do.
She's not a credible witness. Former hooker, drug addict, Lester's ex-girlfriend. I mean, come on. It's her word against Temple's.
Do you believe Temple?
Yeah. I wasn't there. I didn't see it, but
It's not the question I asked you, Detective.
Look, when Lester shot Reese, that was the final straw for Temple. He swore he'd take this guy down.
That doesn't make him guilty. Key to all of this seems to be John Doe, the homeless guy you saw behind the dumpster.
That's a needle in the haystack, Chief. Scott and Taylor have been on that one for the last 3 days. I got no description. It was a shadow.
Detective, I suggest you utilize your detective skills and do something right now. That shadow's the best chance your partner has.
Chief, I'm sure you're aware, but I'm not supposed to be investigating this.
Son, I'm just giving you permission to be more creative, all right? Go.
Right.
Let me give you a flyer here. Jack Mannion, chief of police. What I need you to do is call the mayor's office, tell him that you'd like me back in office again as chief of police. What we're gonna do is refurbish the Howard Theater here. You know this is a landmark? We're gonna open this place up and get her going again, all right?
Yeah,
okay.
Hey.
How you doing? Good morning. Jack Mannion, former chief of police. Really could use your support. Call the mayor's office, tell him you like what I've done, or if you don't like what I've done, I'd appreciate that too. Use your help. I'd like to get back in again. Thank you. Here, I'm Jack Mannion, former chief of police. I was fired for no good reason. I want to get back in office again. I want to be the chief of police. Anybody knows what the word virtuous means? How about honest? How about righteous?
No.
No? Hawk if you love Jack. Jack Mannion, former chief of police. I could use your help. Yeah, I'm Jack Mannion, former chief of police. I don't know if you remember me or not. Jack Mannion, chief of police.
I have spent the last 2 weeks interviewing candidates for the position of chief of police. And I want nothing but the best for this city, so I've taken my time with regards to the decision-making. I've interviewed dozens of qualified law enforcement officials.
Accountability. I will not make a promise I can't keep. Responsibility. We work for you, the people of this community.
I asked you here this afternoon to let you know that I've narrowed the field of candidates down to 3 names, 2 men, 1 woman.
Good afternoon, I called Mr. you up. Mayor.
Have Thank you all for coming.
Yes, Mayor. Gangway, Mr. Mayor. Sir. Wait a minute. Hold it, sir. Mayor, one second, please. Sir.
You're very clever, Jack. But be careful. Cleverness can be mistaken for foolishness.
Considering the source, I'll take that as wise advice.
You know, I had hoped that you would extend to me the same courtesy that I extended to you.
Sir, you fired me.
I still have the tape, Jack.
Well, now we both know if you were going to use it, you would have used it by now, right? I just want my job back.
You're wasting your time.
Hey, sir, you work for the people of the city, and remember, Election Day is not that far away.
Get this son of a bitch.
Are you certain that's what Detective Page said?
Oh, yeah. But this guy was an angry man, hating the world. Somebody close to him had just died. You're saying the guy who got shot, his life isn't worth as much as this lady friend of yours that died?
You know what? I'm gonna get that son of a bitch. I'm gonna feel a whole lot better about things once I get Lester Richards.
Hey, Miss Helen, let me help you with that.
Oh, thank you, Temple. Are you sick? You look so tired.
I just had a long day.
Temple Page, you're under arrest for the murder of Lester Richards.
Come inside.
Turn to your left. Prisoner, turn to your left.
3 years in juvenile hall. 12 assaults. Theft, burglary. He's wanted for 3 murders. I take him out and I'm the one in jail?
You used a civilian as a decoy, Temple. You took action while off duty, without backup. You broke the rules, son. I think that's why you're here.
On this side of the room, right here, that doesn't feel like a fair exchange to me.
You want me to call somebody? Lonnie?
No,
your father?
No. I handle this on my own.
You don't have to.
Why not? You did. Ella died. You lost your job. Why'd you come back?
The people I care about are here. I need to finish what I started, Temple. Yeah, I learned something out in the road, I think. It goes both directions, so I had to make a choice.
Lester reached for his gun, and I had 2 choices. It was either his life or mine.
That's what happened?
Yes, sir.
Hey, fellas. I'm looking for a guy about this tall, all right? Lives in the alley behind the barbershop. Or in mass.
No.
What do you mean, no? You don't even know I'm gonna ask yet. Hey, Sunshine. I'm looking for someone. Lives over behind the barbershop. In the alley there.
Chief, are you sure you don't want to stay in a hotel? I can keep Cujo.
No, this is home, Nancy. Hey, Brent, come on. It's a doorway.
Sorry.
Pull it.
Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Hey, Chief.
I got Temple's IA file, CSU crime scene file.
Great. Hey, Brander, go out there and grab that door, would you? Put it on the sawhorses.
Yes,
we'll use it as a desk.
I had to twist some arms to get these one in particular. This is all going to the U.S. Attorney General's tomorrow. They're going to go before the grand jury.
Where's Tabrino?
He's trying to track down John Doe. If he finds him, it'll be a miracle.
Yeah? Let's pray for one. Thanks for the files, yeah?
What files? All right, everybody, look. This kind of renegade investigation is exactly what got Temple in this mess.
Brander, I want you and Nancy to get over the crime scene.
CSU must have been through that scene 100 times, Chief. What'd you expect us to find that they didn't?
What they missed.
It's like the canary yellow jumpsuit story, Brander.
What?
Now, you never heard the canary yellow jumpsuit story?
No.
Come on, come on. Get over here. Get over here, sit down. Yeah. See, I was in New York. I was working in transit, undercover. I was a decoy, right? And I was wearing this
canary yellow jumpsuit.
So I was making this drug deal, right? And the perp makes me for a cop. So he pulls a gun, we wrestle for it. A shot goes off. Just misses my cheek. Another shot goes off, and it hits him. Now, IA investigates. They can't find the bullet from the first shot anywhere.
The one that just missed you.
Exactly. So it looks like I took the perp's gun, and I shot him.
Until 2 weeks later, they find the bullet lodged in a street sign.
Exactly. 20 yards away. If it hadn't been for some guy cleaning up graffiti, I could have had another career.
At CSU missed it the first time.
Because they were only looking for what they were told to look for.
And that is when he realized that 10% of the cops did 90% of the work. Hence, a legend was born. Lowly transit cop steps into a telephone booth and emerges Jack Mannion, crime fighter. Brander, don't ever ask him to tell that story again before I retire. You hear me?
Yes, trust me.
Come on, we're out of here.
But why, Chief, a canary yellow jumpsuit?
Nancy, get him out of here.
Hey, if you find anything, get it back to Joe.
All right, yes, sir.
Brander.
Yes, sir.
My last week as acting chief, I'm going to exercise the privilege of the office. I am reinstating you.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. Come in tomorrow morning and sign the paperwork.
Thank you, sir.
And remember, the truth has tracks. Find him.
Yes, sir.
Jack Mannion, crime fighter.
I hope I just didn't make a big mistake. Big mistake.
Joe. You do me a favor. You stay with the department.
Jack, what are you talking about? You don't even have a job.
Well, I got kind of a plan. May work out. If the horse comes in, you know, if I get lucky, I'm gonna need you.
Jack, I got a job offer, part-time security for this corporation. Money's good. I can still collect my pension.
Joe. I need you there. All right? I can't do this without you.
All right, we run the race. I make my mind up at the end of it. Deal?
Deal.
Deal.
Hey! Hey, you too! Hey! Come here! MPD, I want to ask you some questions. I'm looking for someone. Lives over in the alley behind the barbershop on R Street.
I don't know nobody.
Get out of here.
Hey, sweetie, how are you? Maybe next time.
Hey, I'm
good.
Excuse me. Mr. Strong?
Officer?
I'd like to ask you a few questions. Yeah, I was there that night. That was my alley, my home. Till you guys turned it into the OK Corral. Yeah, well, I need to know what you saw. Nothing. Look, Mr. Strong, a police officer, my partner, he was there. Whatever you saw, I need to know. And you're not gonna get in any kind of trouble. I just need the truth. Like I said, I didn't see anything. If you're blind, how did you know that I was a cop? That's a mother breastfeeding. Now see, she really enjoying her Jell-O. And then there's you. See, you chewing gum, the stick kind, wrapped in foil. And that sound of metal scraping against metal? That's the pair of handcuffs hanging off your belt. See, every time you move, they rub against each other. Okay. So what did you hear that night in the alley? That's the last thing I heard.
What? Yeah, hold it. Oh, wait a minute, Gwen. Yeah, okay. Hold on. A second.
Come on, open the door.
Okay, I'm coming.
Wake
I'm coming.
Up.
Hey.
Get dressed. We gotta get downstairs. It's an emergency.
What?
Listen, what do you hear?
Destruction, I think.
No, more like destruction of this building.
Yeah, okay. Gwen, what's going on?
You don't want to know the details. Come on, just get dressed. We gotta stop them.
Well, what am I gonna
do? You got handcuffs, right?
Yeah.
Good, bring them. Hey! Hey, what do you think you're doing? You can't tear this building down. Kids live here. People live here. Children live here. You can't tear this building down. What do you think you're doing? Look, I know people down the city hall and they're on their way down here right now. You guys gotta
go. Gwen! What's going on here? What are you doing? Come on. Oh, Gwen.
Look, I'm not going. I'm a squatter, Jack.
Huh? You rented an apartment to me you don't even own?
You're the former chief of police. I figure nobody would dare drive a bulldozer over you. And I'm still counting on that.
Oh, yeah? Well, I know some good lawyers, Gwen.
Oh, I've been there, done that. This place was a rotten hole when I found it. I rebuilt this building myself. I gave this old building life, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna let you take it away.
Well, that's the spirit.
So you with me on this?
I don't think so.
Whose side are you on?
I'm on the side of the law, Gwen.
The law? Squatters have rights too, Mannion. It's called improving the quality of life. These people live here because I made it clean and safe. I started a Saturday school because around here, people work two and three jobs. Now their kids aren't wandering the streets while the parents are struggling to provide.
Hey, lady, can you please remove yourself from the premises?
Yeah, bring it on anyway.
Oh, I thought you were serious about living here. Oh, but I get it. This isn't your fight. Because this really isn't your home. Get off my stoop.
Now, wait a minute. You can't order me off a stoop. You don't even know the stoop. All right. Rowboat driver looks serious. I don't know. Not your stoop anymore, the stoop.
I don't think you're going to be able to save this building, Gwen.
Hey! Former chief! chief of police. Now get with that.
Okay, that's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, call him. He's famous. Jack Mannion, call him.
All right, I'll talk to Joe Nolan. He'll come over and help us out. Again, I wish I'd dressed for this.
Jack Mannion's not only campaigning for his job as chief of police, he's also fighting corporate America by trying to save a building.
And she's good. I mean, isn't she?
Oh, yeah, she's one of the best. That's the reason lawyers have such a bad name, is because of her. Underneath that petite exterior is a legal terminator. I'm making it meet out of those people.
Miss Hendricks, you have 24 hours to vacate the premises.
I thought you said she was good.
I'm not going anywhere. Just try and move
me. You're making me look bad here, Cabby.
Landlord, tenant, and real estate law are not my specialty, Jack. Stoddard Foods owns the building. They acquired it in the merger 20 years ago from Hillcrest Baking.
Hillcrest Baking?
Yes.
That's Hillcrest Cakes, isn't it? Remember those? Oh, man. Can't get enough of them, enough of them, enough of them. Can't get enough of them.
Is he always like this? All but the kimono.
Oh, come on, just have a little fun.
This is no time to have fun, Jack.
How old's the building?
Well, this is over 100 years old because my grandfather worked here as a child.
How about we get it declared as a historical landmark?
No, I thought about that, but then I run the risk of them knowing that I was living here.
I think they know.
Would it work?
Look, we don't have that much time, and I still don't own this building.
Look, Jack's right. Once we file the historical paperwork, these guys can't touch us. Don't move.
We'll be right here.
I'm filing a petition. I don't think you realize this is the
only statue in the city that's a pet.
President Roosevelt's dog, Fala.
You know, you don't know everything. I'm going to get you.
You ever get enough of those Hillcrest cakes?
All right.
All right, this is where Temple took the shot.
Now, move down the stairs towards Lester's position. Are you there?
Yeah.
Are you sure this is the window she was in?
I'm positive, Nance. There's a diagram in the file.
This can't be the window.
Brander! I can't see anything!
That's gotta be the window, Nance. It's the only one she could have been standing in.
Ernie Paulson signed off on this report. How could he have missed this?
Well, he's not one of those CSU guys. He was a jock. He played basketball at Virginia Commonwealth.
Brander, how tall is Ernie?
I don't know. 6'6", give or take a yard. Why?
She didn't see it, Brander. Maria Rodriguez didn't see anything.
We're closed. I told you we're closed.
Jasmine, open up. I need to talk to you.
What do you want? What do you want now?
You can open this door or you can collect overtime waiting for the repairman to replace the glass. What's it gonna be, huh?
Why'd you lie?
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's no way you could have seen what happened from that window.
Look, for the last time, I saw Lester try to surrender. Your friend shot him. End of story.
Were you afraid of Lester's crew? Huh? Did someone threaten you, Kashmir?
Don't call me that! My name is Maria Rodriguez. And I saw what I saw, okay?
Well, Maria, if you tell me the truth, perhaps I can help you.
Just get out of here.
Oh, come on. Don't do this. Don't live with a lie.
Detective Pace didn't have to kill him.
What, so lying was payback? For your pimp boyfriend?
I was afraid. I was scared that Lester's people would find out that I was the one who set him up. I didn't know what else to do. I didn't know that it would go this far.
What did you see?
Nothing.
fact that woman lied doesn't change the fact that you had a vendetta. You went after that man and killed him.
Get out of my face.
It is an honor to be appointed police chief of the District of Columbia.
If it's any consolation, I didn't vote for Mayor Douglas.
That's something we have in common.
I know about your dog.
What dog?
Oh, please, don't try it. That four-legged bath rug that you listed on the lease as your roommate.
It's a friend of mine. His name is Cujo. He just looks like a dog.
Well, I want you to know that I've never met a cop that I liked. It's the uniform, that blue. They just ruined the color blue for me. The cops and the Colts.
Colts?
Yeah. They left Baltimore in the middle of the night, moved to Indianapolis, and things have never been the same. Just broke my father's heart.
You know something, Gwen? I think you and I are going to have a beautiful relationship.
Now, when did you say they're coming with the keys? The next time you bring the handcuffs, don't forget the keys.
How do you spell your last name? H-E-N-T-R-I-X?
Why?
You any relation to Jimi Hendrix?
Don't know. Never.
Come on.
Come on.
All along the watchtower. All along the watchtower. Preserves kept the view. While all the women